The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. This game seems to be full of mysteries, causing fans to go insane, pulling their hair out, trying to answer them. Today, we're going to try solving a few of these mysteries. Specifically, why are certain goddess statues glowing while others aren't? Why does Link wake up and not remember who he is? I mean, doesn't most Zelda games begin with Link waking up and he seems to be fine in them, right? So why the sudden amnesia in this game? And lastly, will this game feature some form of time travel? Well, click that subscribe button and follow along as we try to solve this together.
The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild begins as many Zelda games do. Link hears a voice calling for him. We wake up from La La Land before stepping out into the world and having a meaningful conversation with a character who plays an important role in the story. In this case, that character is simply known as the Old Man. After raising the first Sheikah Tower and witnessing this cutscene showing Calamity Ganon, the Old Man asks Link if he remembers anything, and seems disappointed with Link's answer. So why does Link not remember anything, especially after witnessing these major events? You would think something would jog his memory, right?
Miyamoto during E3 said that you would come to understand what has happened to Hyrule and discover who Link is as you progress through the game, and come upon different villages, which is one of the reasons they said they didn't show off any villages during the demo. He wanted the players to get a sense of what the game was while being as spoiler-free as possible. At this point, fans understand the main driving point of the game will be restoring Link's memories and coming to understand what has happened to Hyrule. It wasn't until the Game Awards that Nintendo gave us any more substantial details, but Nintendo did reveal one short trailer between E3 and the Game Awards that sparked questions among fans. Nintendo revealed a short trailer showing off the Temple of Time and its ruined state. However, one thing stood out that wasn't there before. The statue of the goddess located inside the ruined Temple of Time is now glowing. This is important to note because in all previous gameplay videos we have seen, this same statue wasn't glowing.
Finally, we come to the Game Awards, when we see two more trailers that act as the final pieces of the puzzle. The first trailer shows a female who we can assume is Zelda and Link with the Master Sword. But wait, the Master Sword is in perfect condition. Or at least, the sheath is, and something just seems off. Link is wearing the blue hero's clothes, or the champion's shirt we are used to seeing him in, but doesn't have the Sheikah Slate. But we know that the Sheikah Slate is one of the very first items we receive in the game. Almost every piece of gameplay and cutscene we have seen of Link has had him with the Sheikah Slate, but in this cutscene, it is clearly missing. Putting all this together leads many to believe that these scenes are actually taking place in the past, before Link falls asleep, before the Master Sword is damaged, and before he receives the Sheikah Slate. Then during the second trailer, which is heavily edited and is way too careful not to show too much during the Let's Play, they make it very obvious that they want us to focus on the glowing statue. But they make it a point to stop the game before we get too close. Now why would that be? Unless it is something that is key to the story and, like at E3, they don't want to spoil it for us.
Well, this is where all of the dots start to connect. We see this goddess statue is located close to a shrine. But this doesn't seem like just any shrine. This gives me the feeling of a full dungeon, not just a mini dungeon or shrine. First off, none of the shrines we have seen so far have had someone giving us a riddle to solve in order to find it. They may have enemies somewhere in the area, but none of them seem to be protecting the entrance or keeping you from getting too close. And finally, none have a goddess statue glowing at the entrance. Now, I would like to go back to the glowing statue in the Temple of Time. While we don't know if the Temple of Time in Breath of the Wild will be a dungeon, in past Zelda games, it has acted as a place that holds the Master Sword. It has been the gateway to the Sacred Realm, it has been a way of traveling back and forth through time on more than one occasion, and it's also acted as a dungeon, as well as the entrance to the Chamber of Sages. So, with the statue of the goddess glowing inside the Temple of Time in Breath of the Wild, it is very likely at one point in the game, something important will happen with the Temple of Time. Whether it is used again as a way to travel back and forth through time, or a hidden room opens up allowing us to receive the Master Sword, or we use it to enter a new dungeon or area, I believe the Temple of Time will play a very important role just as it has in past Zelda games. Now, back to the glowing statues. I believe these are located close to what will be the dungeons of the game, and act in the same way they did in Skyward Sword. In Skyward Sword, Zelda finds out she is the reincarnation of the goddess Hylia. She needs to seek out the individual goddess statues inside each of the dungeons, in Skyward Sword, in order to pray at them and unlock her lost memories. In the same way, during Breath of the Wild, Link wakes up in the Shrine of Resurrection. It is hinted at by Nintendo he is a past hero being resurrected. So, just like Zelda in Skyward Sword, perhaps Link needs to travel to these different statues, and once he prays at them, a new memory is unlocked. These memories, I believe, come in the form of these cutscenes, like the one we received during the Game Awards, which shows Link without the Sheikah Slate and with a Master Sword that seems to be in perfect condition. These memories could potentially be playable, but all we have seen so far points to them just being cutscenes. So, while it is potentially possible that time travel will play a role in Breath of the Wild, it looks like it will be visions from the past instead of actual playable moments.
Nintendo has said time and time again that you can go in any direction you want and do anything you want in any order you want. So let's say that there are 10 full dungeons. I believe we will have a cutscene linked to each one of these dungeons for each one of the statues located close to the dungeon. This is where the confusing part may come into play, as I'm not sure how this will work exactly. The statues and memories could work in two potential ways. In one, it may not matter which statue or dungeon you reach first. You won't get the cutscene in a mixed order, and you'll always get the first cutscene or flashback first. If I go to the statue we've seen in the jungle area and you go to the one in Death Mountain, or they will both give you the same cutscene first. The other way is that each statue could have its own unique memory and cutscene linked specifically to that one. Personally, I would be fine with either. The first way would ensure certain aspects to come later in the game won't be spoiled. For instance, you could see a scene that involves a character or location you have yet to see, so when you happen to come across that character or area, the surprise may be ruined for you. But the second would make everyone's playthroughs completely different, as receiving the story in a different order than someone would lead you to piecing together an entirely different story than your friend, and lead to better conversations about what you discovered on your adventure in this huge world.
What's up everybody, Game Over Jesse here, and thank you for watching this video. If you want an even more in-depth analysis, check out Zelda Informer's other video here on the left, and if you would like to see more videos similar to this from myself, check out my channel by clicking the video on the right.